Welcome everyone, respected sir, ma'am, and my dear members of Omics Bootcamp India Journal Club. Today, my topic of presentation is green synthesis of carbon quantum dots, scatteration, and its applications. Points to be covered: history of nanotechnology, carbon quantum dots, green synthesis of carbon quantum dots, scatteration, applications, omics in nanotechnology, role of nanotechnologies in proteomics, nanoproteomics, and microarray. Nanotechnology is an interdisciplinary field which deals with materials lies in the size range from 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer. Nanomaterials have been used since ancient times. Lycurgus cup, a glass made by Romans in 4th century, it contains nanoparticles like silver, copper, and gold, dispersed in a glass matrix. Then in 18th century, nanoparticles have been found in the sword of Tipu Sultan. Tipu Sultan, the ruler of erstwhile kingdom of Mysore in India, had a sword made up of Damascus steel. In 1959, the American physicist quoted, "There's plenty of room at the bottom." Richard Feynman, the father of nanotechnology. Carbon quantum dots are nanostructures having sp2 properties. Several functional groups found on the surface of carbon quantum dots, as shown in the figure also. Large carbon quantum dots appear red or orange in color, whereas small carbon quantum dots appear blue and green in color. Carbon quantum dots, as we know that carbon is the basic element of in a cell. Carbon quantum dots are biocompatible, low toxicity, and obtained from cheap raw materials. Photostable, high chemical stability, have broadband optical absorption, easy to synthesize at large scale, environmental friendly. These qualities depend on its size and surface chemistry. To prepare carbon quantum dots, there are two approaches: top-down approach and bottom-up approach. Top-down approach involves the particle size reduction at nanoscale, whereas bottom-up approach involves the growth of nanoparticles from atomic size particles. In top-down approach, all particles in the precursor may not break down to the required particle size, whereas in bottom-up approach, more control over particle size have been reported. Here are few processes in top-down and bottom-up approaches. In top-down, laser ablation, chemical oxidation, ultrasonic treatment. And in bottom-up approach, microwave synthesis, thermal decomposition, hydrothermal treatment are involved. Every process have its own merits and demerits. Modes of preparation of carbon quantum dots. There are three modes: physical methods, green methods, and chemical methods. Carbon dots derived from natural sources are more biocompatible and less toxic to environment and human beings. Natural sources are easily available and abundant in enzymes, phytochemicals, and other organic substances. Few examples of carbon quantum dots prepared from natural sources are: carbon dots prepared from these sources are highly fluorescent, found to be less toxic, and have been applied in several fields. Scatteration of carbon quantum dots. Scatteration of carbon quantum dots is a crucial phase while synthesizing carbon quantum dots. These techniques help us to know more about our prepared carbon quantum dots. Like UV scatteration help us to detect the formation of carbon dots and their fluorescence. X-ray diffraction help us to know whether the prepared carbon dot is amorphous or crystalline in nature. XPS help us to study surface chemistry of carbon dots, whereas photoluminescence help us to detect if there is any surface defects. FTIR help us to study the surface chemistry by functional groups present on the surface of carbon quantum dots. Scanning electron microscope is used to study the surface of carbon dots, and transmission electron microscope help us to measure the shape and size of carbon dots. There are plenty of applications of carbon dots in several fields, like biosensors are manufactured using carbon dots, nano devices and chips are used in drug delivery, bioimaging, mainly used in fluorescence-based techniques, such as protein sensing, iron detection, etc. I have prepared carbon quantum dots using curry leaves. It was aqueous medium solution kept under high temperature and pressure for 6 hours in Muffel furnace. After the reaction, I obtained a brown colored solution. Blue fluorescence obtained under UV rays. Blue fluorescence indicates formation of carbon dots and its small size. Curry leaves. I have selected curry leaves because curry leaves are rich in antioxidants and alkaloids. And we know that plants rich in secondary metabolites gives better yield. Hydrothermal treatment was performed in Muffel furnace, which have a Teflon container. And here we put our samples under high temperature and high pressure. TEM results confirms that carbon quantum dots, which I have prepared, are from 1 nanometer to 100 to 3 nanometer in size, as you can see in the image. And due to such small size from 1 nanometer to 3 nanometer, it emitted blue fluorescence under UV light. FTIR result helped me to know the surface chemistry of my prepared carbon dots. And in this graph, we can see hydroxyl group, alkaline, nitrile, carbonyl group, and amine group. In amine group, there's a sharp peak, and phenyl group is also present. Omics in nanotechnology. Omics-based approaches can be used to study the vast nanomaterial chemical space, as well as biological factors that affect the safety, toxicity, and efficacy of nanotechnologies. Omics give us more clear and insightful vision of biological systems. One way sequencing may improve nanomedicine is by making the preclinical pipeline used to discover nanomaterials more efficiently. Omics in nanotechnology. When plants are treated with engineered nanomaterials, omics have been used to study the phenotypic expression along with detailed explanation of associated biological pathways. Omics help us to study mechanism in detail, exactly where carbon quantum dots are interacting with biomolecules or pathways. Now the question arises, so what is the relationship between nanotechnologies and proteomics? How can nanotechnology be beneficial for proteomics applications? Nanotechnology can reduce difficulties and help to draw new information out of biological systems. In the field of nanotechnology, have been associated with several proteomic applications, such as phosphoproteomics, nanostructure surfaces for protein separation, and analytical detection of biomarker proteins using array technologies. Nanoproteomics. When nanotechnology and proteomics work together, it generates nanoproteomics, which is defined as a discipline of science involving the application of proteomics techniques aided by nanotechnology to enhance probing and evaluating protein systems. Studying gene expression using DNA microarrays. DNA microarray is one of the best method for whole transcriptome gene expression profiling in toxicogenomic studies. These are valuable tools for assessing toxicity. It gives us much insight into the transcriptomics of nanomaterial exposed cells and their risks to public health and the environment. As you can see in the slide, there are two cells. One is cancer cell and the other one, both cells are cancer cell. One is normal cancer cell and another one is treated with carbon quantum dots. DNA microarray utilizes nucleic acid probes that are attached to a slide that hybridize with fluorescence. Fluorescently labeled DNA target sequences that are then scanned and processed. DNA microarray is a reliable method and more cost-effective compared to RNA sequencing. DNA microarray is still valid and implemented in gene expression investigations. We get result as four different colors: red, green, yellow, and black. Every color have its own significance. Like red color indicates particular gene expressed in only cancer cells, which are untreated. Green colors signifies particular gene expressed in cancer cell when treated with carbon quantum dots. Yellow color shows us particular gene expressed in both cells, treated as well as in untreated. Black color denotes no expression. Why microarray? Microarray, thousands of genes can be measured and analyzed simultaneously. When cells are treated with carbon quantum dots, DNA microarray help us to study different type of expression with gene are getting more expressed, which genes are less expressed. In omics era, technological advancement in genomics, proteomics, metabolomics have generated large scale of data sets in every aspects of biology. Such huge data set encourages the computational biology systems approaches with objective of understanding the biological systems. Conclusion. The nanotechnology materials and their application in proteomics research has proved successfully overcoming several technical limitations and roadblocking associated with proteomics analysis, including biological complexities, sensitivity, and dynamic range. These ultra-sensitive high-throughput technological platforms have opened doors to the rapid detection of low abundance proteins from complex and clinically relevant biological samples, facilitating the identification and characterization of biomarkers for human diseases, potential candidates for clinical applications. Nanotechnology have been used as a complementary component to revolutionize the proteomics throughout different kinds of technology applications. Nanotechnology acknowledgement. I would like to express my gratitude to Dr. Sanjeeva sir for giving me this golden opportunity. I am grateful to Dr. Radhika ma'am, who is being my inspiration and constant source of motivation. I am grateful to my mentor, Dr. Priyanka Vyas, for her guidance throughout each stage of the process. Dr. Arup Acharya sir, and the whole team of Omics Bootcamp India. And I have performed all my experiments in biophysics and nanotechnology lab at IIT BHU Varanasi. These are the references. Thank you. Thank you so much.